Hey, what's going on today, B's and G's? So happy homebrew Wednesday. That's for you, Wally. Well, you can't start a homebrew Wednesday without a homebrew. So this is my Azokzilla. It's an all Azoka hop pale ale. Turned out pretty decent. Real clear. Good little, maybe one finger head on it. But it's still pretty young. Put it in the keg. Got it all carved up. And it turned, in my opinion, it turned out pretty good. So, cheers to y'all. So, craziness stuff going on. So, like I said, I'm going to brew this Rogue Chocolate Stout today. My wife's about killed the keg on the last one. And, so we're going to rebrew it today. So, we'll kick off to a little bit of brew footage. Not a whole lot, but hey, it is what it is. So, I've got my Stone Mountain IPA down in the basement doing its thing. It's been bubbling away since last Friday. It's kind of slowed down today, so we'll see how it goes. But I plan on transferring that over into the secondary on Friday. And then dry hopping it with 2 ounces of Centennial. And then I think I'm going to let it hang out for probably about 10, maybe 15 more days in secondary before I actually cold crash it and put it in the keg. But it smells amazing. I've been down, you know, checking it back and forth just to make sure it didn't blow the airlock off. But it's been a pretty good fermentation on that beer. I fermented it with US05. And so yeah, it's coming along pretty good. Other news. So I got in the mail yesterday some Bonlander Munich. So y'all know what that means. I'm gonna rebrew my Dropkick Nate. Actually, Nate's and Elder's Dropkick Nate, their recipe. So I'm gonna go through and try and rebrew that. I sent that off to Brad and Nate the first time that I did it. And, you know, they brought up some great information. I use an aquifer just down the road from me and for my brewing water. However, in my Star Sand, when I bottled those beers, and for all my cleaning and sanitation as far as that's concerned, I've been using just tap water. They picked up on it, which, you know, I didn't at the time. But Brad and Nate picked up on the chlorine that I used in Star Sand. So that's, you know, that's what I love about this community. You know, you send out beers, you get good, honest reviews, and you can make improvements on your own beer. And so I'm going to rebrew that beer, and Brad and Nate, I'm going to send you out another bottle, maybe two, since y'all are in different locations now. But once that beer's done, I'm hoping to brew it this coming weekend. But once that beer's done, I'm going to send a couple out to y'all. Because I want to, you know, see if it's improved or not. Ooh, excuse me. But yeah, so I'm going to brew the Dropkick Nate this coming weekend and kind of go from there. Let's see what else. So I got an email from Mr. Josh Hoover and my SJ Poor Challenge beers should be coming back to me tomorrow. So I'm really excited to go ahead and try those, the beers of the challenge from all those that have brewed it in the West Coast. Hope you don't die when you taste mine, but hey, it is what it is. No, but seriously, you know, a big shout out to Josh and everybody who's involved in the SJ Pour Challenge, you know, the inner workings. I know they said this on my last video, but hey, I really appreciate it, and I know a lot of other brewers do as well. But I'm looking forward to getting those brews hopefully tomorrow so that I can go ahead and start doing the reviews on them. And again, I think this is an amazing amazing community, amazing challenge. Mr. SJ Poor himself, you know, involved everybody in this. And so, yeah, I'm looking forward to it, if you can't tell. But I've been talking too much. Cheers. Yeah, so I'm going to rebrew the Dropkick Nate. Brewing my Rogue Chocolate Stout today. And we'll kind of go from there. Other news. So it looks like that I tore my left MCL. And so on the 23rd of this month, I get to go in and have that repaired. And so going to go in, get the knee fixed, see how that goes, kind of go from there. So hopefully, while I'm incapacitated with the knee surgery, I might be able to maybe brew a little bit more. But we'll see how that goes. All right, well, I've rambled on for about almost 7 minutes now. But hey, guys, you know, I really appreciate all the feedback and everything, the comments that I get in my videos. It's all great. Great feedback, great information. I really enjoy doing these. Like I said, in a few videos back, I didn't start doing these until, a great brewer, an amazing brewer within this community passed away, Mr. Paul Weeksteed. I think about him often, think about his videos all the time, and just this community is amazing, absolutely amazing, and he's just a part of it. So a big shout out to everybody out here that's doing videos and camming up and showing their brewing footage, showing their beer reviews, and doing all that kind of stuff. It's pretty amazing. But anyway, so yeah, I'll kick off to a little bit of brew footage, not a whole lot, but we'll kind of go from there. But anyway, I hope you guys have a great, amazing, happy homebrew Wednesday, and we'll catch y'all next week. All right, take care. Okay, well, this recipe, it calls for a mash in at 150. That's pretty damn good. I'm excited about that. All right. Okay, so we're fly sparging this out, and it looks absolutely amazing. Black, black, black. Looks like we're coming up on a boil here. So first hop drop, 1 ounce of Cascade. Here we go. There we go. All right, well, not sure if you can see that or not, but about 1065. 30 minute mark, 1 more ounce of Cascade. Okay, end of boil, 1 last ounce of Cascade. Here we go. Well, we're supposed to be 1065. Not sure if you can see that or not. But we overshot it by just a little bit, maybe a 1070. But that's all good. Hey, putting in the sanitized fermenter. Okay, guys. Little over about 5.5 gallons collected. Good looking. And we threw the Y-Yeast 1056 in there. All right. Well, we'll get her bubbling.